We just arrived in Alexandria. Alexandria is one of the oldest ports in the world. Do you see the castle at the entry of the port? Once there stood the famous Pharos lighthouse. They say it was 120 meters high. The lighthouse got its name from the small island on which it was built more than 2,000 years ago. It remained there for 16 centuries until it collapsed during an earthquake in 1303 and was not rebuilt. The castle was built on the ruins of the lighthouse. Its construction was finished in 1480. Alexandria owes its name to the Greek emperor and warrior Alexander the Great. In 313 before Christ, he landed with his soldiers on the coast near the island of Pharos. He saw that Pharos could be connected to the coast with a dam so that two harbors would emerge on either side of the dam. He wanted to create a Mediterranean port that would link Egypt's fame and grain with the Mediterranean world he dominated. For millennia, there have been economic ties between Egypt and Greece. Both countries were part of a Mediterranean trade network stretching from the Nile region to the coasts of the Middle East, to Greece, and from there to the North African coast. Alexandria was not only a center of science, but also an important marketplace and world port. It was a crossroads of sea roads and caravan routes between Africa, Asia, and Europe. With the conquest of Egypt by the Romans in 30 before Christ, the destruction and loss of the library and museum, the rise of Christianity with its religious disputes and repression of dissenters, the invasion of the Arabs in 641, the glory and tolerance of Alexandria faded away. Alexandria had the largest library and museum of the ancient world and served as a meeting place and a melting pot of the great cultures and spirits of that time. Thanks to scientists coming to Alexandria, enormous progress was made in the fields of mathematics, astronomy, medicine, geography, philosophy, and theology. We arrive at the famous new-built library and will visit it. But first we will meet an Egyptian young lady who sings in the opera Carmen. She has invited us to attend a rehearsal later that day. On the terrace of a cafe at the library, she introduces us to the Hungarian-German soprano who will perform Carmen. We take a walk through the neighborhood where our apartment is. Our guide is Ibrahim, the former curator of the Harbor Museum, who grew up in this neighborhood.
Incroyable, c'est comme une ferme là-bas.
Entrez, madame.
Guitarra, guitarra, por favor, abres-me o peito com sabe de dor. Guitarra, emudece o som que me entristece, vertendo sobre mim a nostalgia. Oh, guitarra, guitarra.
We are at the Port Training Institute, where dock workers from Egypt and other African countries are trained as crane operators, logistics personnel and truck drivers. Mohamed Abdelaziz, head of the research department, gives us a tour of the building. We see simulation equipment for cranes and trucks. We see classrooms for electronics, chemistry, machine repair and safety.
Yes.
L'ancien et moderne, et maintenant, Alexandrie, c'est une banque de terre.
Oui.
Ibrahim, the former curator of the Port Museum, now works with the Port Training Institute. Before we visit the port with him as a guide, he tells us about the history of the port. The port has three functions: commercial, tourist, and it is a naval port.
Oslo, c'est plant.
Oslo, wave.
Oslo, plant.
Norvège.
Norvège?
Yeah.
Norvège.
Scandinavia.
Oui, oui. Oui, oui. Mais vous, c'est possible, peut-être un peu après.
Un peu.
Par exemple, ici.
Par exemple, ici.
Ouais. Ah, oui, c'est une belle ville.
Le poids, décharger le poids.
déchargé de voir. Sur c'est Maoun. Sur Maoun. Maoun.
Egypt has been involved in global trade since ancient times due to its geographical location at the intersection of three continents, Asia, Africa, and Europe, and its 2,000 kilometer long coastline on the Mediterranean and the Red Sea. The Egyptian government wants to expand six of its ports in order to meet the growing demand in maritime trade and transform Egypt into a hub for global trade and logistics. The Port of Alexandria is the largest port in the country. Around 60% of Egypt's exports and imports are processed here. A new multi-purpose terminal is being built. It will take up an area of approximately 56 hectares. It's enormous. The new terminal is part of Egypt's strategic plans to advance the transport sector and establish development corridors and logistics zones and connect various ports with railways and roads. The new terminal will strengthen the country's transit and re-export services. We are at the locks of the Mamoudiya Canal, which used to connect the Mediterranean with the Nile. The canal was built in 1840 by the governor Muhammad Ali on the site of an earlier canal. When a railway was constructed in 1856, to connect the port with countries deeper in Africa, the canal became less important and silted up. In a restaurant, we have a conversation with an Egyptian economist. From our table, we almost see the apartment where we are staying.
Έχετε ψητή σαρδέλα, έχετε ψητή σαρδέλα.
This is our last day in Alexandria.